Law Center says these anti-government militia groups are gaining ground in the Midwest, Pacific Northwest, and the Deep South. It points to several reasons.
I will not be a slave to the New World Order. I will uphold the Constitution.
We're kind of the ultimate check and balance, I suppose. I don't want a revolution. I don't want a civil war. I would hate for that to happen. But it is a possibility. It's there as an option, as a last resort, should our government turn on its own people.
I'm actually very new to the resistance movement. I've probably only been awake with the situation for maybe the last year or so.
Targets.
Patriot movement is basically listing all kinds of different organizations all across the United States, looking at militias or maybe the American Resistant Movement, the umbrella organization, may have the Ohio Militia or Michigan Militia or whatever militias all over the place, citizens militias like in San Diego. They're all under the Patriot movement, and we're trying to take back this republic and restore this republic like it's supposed to be, what it was intended by our founders. Then he is an oath keeper. There you go. It's that simple.
Now we're at Escondido, California, at Mr. Paintball, and we come out here to play airsoft and do a little training and stuff. I normally meet some militia members from San Diego. Some of my guys help train their guys, since all my guys are Marines and they're all civilians. We need a citizen militia. We need a citizen militia to defend us from the government, basically. That's the only reason we have the Second Amendment, is to defend the American people and our country from a tyrannical government, which is what we're heading toward right now.
What's that left point? We are definitely the guardians of the Republic and the last stand if something comes down. Because the military, they fall under the UCMJ, and a lot of people will follow any order just for fear of being thrown in prison and put in the brig. There's a lot of us that will defy orders as long as for the Constitution and the Constitution. We know what this is all about. We know why we're here. We're very strong in our beliefs and our origins. We realize that the reasons we're in Iraq and Afghanistan right now are not as good as people think they are. Right now we're doing nothing other than feeding the industrial military complex and creating debt for the Federal Reserve, which isn't even a federal organization, so that they can enslave us and control us. So, join the military? Depends on what you want to do with it. Me, I'm going to use my training in the military, and I suppose become one of those domestic terrorists that you're so afraid of from the DHS and their reports. Ridiculous. Really?
Last day of service uniform. Two ribbons on my breast. For Canada. Shooting with a badge and everything. At the tank, Dallas Fort Worth, on my layover. Search my bags, my gear, everything.
We're definitely targets now. Military. We are targets. And that is sad. That's sad. I've been to Iraq. You know, I've been deployed. I've got nothing but the strongest feelings for my country. Having Marines die over there. And then we come home, and those bastards want to talk about how we're domestic terrorists and a threat to this country. It makes me so angry. It just saddens me to think that we come back and we're treated like that by our government. You know, I've got one of my Marines right here being detained for hours. Because he's in uniform trying to get into the metal detectors in an airport. It's ridiculous. Ridiculous. Things have to change. It can't go on like this. Something has to be done.
I've got this breaking news. National Security Watch, 60 right-wing owners, people buying all these guns and ammo. This is the number one terror threat.
It's like Vietnam. It's not a winnable war. It's just sustainable. The longer we stay over there, the more debt they can put on us.
Look at what did the president say? We were going to be out of there as soon as he got in office, pretty much. How long has he been president now? And we're still in Iraq. Saw some stuff over there that kind of changed my mind. We lost a good Marine. Sat there and I kept staring at the bodies that were laying around, and it hit me that these guys are nothing but me. You know, they're not terrorists. They're guys that are defending their country. You know, they're not terrorists. The guys in Afghanistan, they're not terrorists. They're defending their country from a foreign invasion. We create terrorists. You come to my house and you kill my wife, you kill my daughter, you kill any part of my family, and I'm probably going to strap on a suicide vest and go to one of your checkpoints. So that's what we're creating over there, in my mind. All I have to say about that situation.
When you go into combat, you are really now a stranger in a strange land.
Patriots, we are not overpowered. We unite under one banner of freedom, fight for our children's liberty, and the defense of the Constitution. Our resolve is invisible to any standing army. They might be able to take the very breath from our lungs, but they can never rip the freedoms from our souls.
And a language is not benign. You have to get people to talk in a language of violence before they can.
Are you feeling lucky, New World Order?
Awesome. I am a kid who works for many years at the New World Order, and I just want to be part of this. I'm really more of a follower.
I think that lives, our men, and our friends, and our families, for our freedom and the Constitution.
We don't play games. We quit school because they had recess. You put us out of work, you stole our pension, so we found us a new job. It's called chewing gum and kicking butt, and guess what? I'm about on my last piece of chewing gum. And I know you've done speaking stuff, and I've got the documents right here in front of me. Let me move this 50 caliber right here, and I'll shove up your nose and blow you away if you mess with American Patriots.
I love my country, and that's why I have to discourage people from joining the military with this guy in the White House. You want to protect your country, join them, or start a militia. But you don't want Obama to be your commander-in-chief.
So you have these forces unleashed and amplified by a mass media in a society that stands on the cusp of disintegration. And remember that within American society, there's a deep undercurrent of violence.
Back in the 90s, there was a militia movement where the government tries to blame the militia movement for that. No matter what, in any movement, any group, there's always going to be crazies. There's always going to be the people that are extreme one way or the other, and they think that killing people, just killing people, period, is going to make a difference, and it's not. It's absolutely not.
For those that don't understand this, we are at a historic crossroads, and I can see it in their eyes and their actions. I realize they're actually intimidated. They realize that they've put their criminal action into motion. It's a machine they can't turn off, and I think they're starting to brace for the fact. I mean, it's like when you get in a fight, some bully punches you, and then you gear up and start punching back, and you can tell you're going to whoop their ass. I mean, that's the feeling right here. We are going to kick the New World Order's butt.
There's no way we're gonna be able to get outflanked that dude unless we go way back here. There's some people that think something's gonna happen within the next 2 months. There's some people that think something's gonna happen in 2 years. There's some people that think nothing will ever happen. So I guess time is the only thing that can answer that.
We are headed towards civil unrest. We have disempowered our working class, and there are whole pockets now in the United States that resemble the third world, where the end of the world is no longer an abstraction. Violence is a kind of cleansing agent because the world around them is one that has betrayed and that they hate. And that is the allure of apocalyptic violence. It eradicates what almost destroyed me.
I just want to ask the American people to wake up, see what's going on around you, walk outside, stop playing your video games, stop watching your TV.
In a corporate state, the interests and needs of citizens don't matter. You need to destroy the machine. Because if we don't destroy the machine's going to destroy us. It is destroying us.
Vote, become politically involved, or start a militia, which is very important. Do something. Do something to make yourself better and more prepared for what may be coming. I'm not going to be hiding from my command anymore, and I'm sure not hiding from ATF, I'm not hiding from FBI, I'm not hiding from any organization. If they want to come take me, I'm not going to be afraid. If I'm afraid to that point, we're in a tyrannical government in the first place, and people need to rise up. At that point, there needs to be a violent revolution.